Hey, this is Ben, and welcome to HotDogCartStore.com, LearnHotDogs.com, and HotDogCartVendor.com. And what I've received today was an email with some pictures. I think I actually received this yesterday, but some pictures that a brand new vendor, just started vending and wanted to get a critique, basically some constructive criticism. And I've done these before, and I'll provide the links down below in the description area, and you can take a look at those if it'll help you. Sometimes the smallest little things, like the lady in Florida that we moved her over like three or four parking spots, just because I looked at Google Maps and looked at her location, moved her over three or four parking spaces in the same parking lot, and her business, well, it doubled immediately, but some days it tripled immediately, all because just little things. So this is a brand new vendor. First day vending was April 28th, which was, as of recording of this, was 6 days ago, roughly. So this is the, I'm going to scroll through here and show you. This is the cart, and you can see back here in the background, there's some businesses around. Looks like a car garage, a repair garage, and then looks like some kind of restaurant over there to the left. And now the cart, if you notice, chip clips are hanging, looks great. Okay, that always looks good. Now I would suggest having more chip clips is always better. Like if you can only display, like see the ones down here on the corner, I would have those up here on the umbrella. She probably has those there to access them easier for the customer. And that's great, but you may want to put them somewhere different. So the more you have of something displayed, the better it looks instead of it looking sparse. Drinks displayed is wonderful. And if you notice, she's displayed all the labels out so people can see what types of drinks are in the coolers below. I'll show you the coolers right there. So, and she's got it labeled, okay? And then she's got her menu. Now, if you notice, cart is clean, and obviously it's a brand new cart. It looks brand new. It's a pretty cart. The red and yellow umbrella looks sharp. Now I'm looking, I wanna look down here. Another thing I noticed here was that she's got her labels out, but she's also got everything set up so the customer knows which side of the cart to come to. It's kind of indicated by where everything is. The chips, the drinks, the sign, the soda, cooler, everything is right there and easily, it's easy to identify which place to go to. Now let's look at this menu real quick. The menu looks good. Okay, it says jumbo dog $4, hot dog combo is two hot dogs $6, Polish combo, turkey dog, chips, Gatorade, Vienna 100% all beef. If you're in an area where people know what Vienna all beef is, then great. If you're not, if you're in the South for the most part, I wouldn't go with Vienna. I just wouldn't. Most people when in the South, if they're from the South, think of Vienna sausages in a little can that we took on hunting and camping trips, fishing trips, and they're real mushy hot dogs. And it's the same company name, and it confuses people. I tried this, and it was to my detriment that I did. I shouldn't have done it. I brought in Vienna, and I thought I was going to, you know, start serving. And, well, what ended up happening is I have to educate my consumer first. Hold on. That's not the same Vienna, different Vienna. These are Chicago dog Vienna. And, now you got to educate. It isn't worth the trouble. Always go with something either recognizable or just all beef hot dog. Even if you want to carry Vienna in the South, I just wouldn't have the Vienna name because it is indicative of little mushy sausages in a can for the Southern folk. All right. So that's this picture. I'm going to show you another one here. This is another view. Here she is standing in front of her cart. If you notice to the left, there's a Pizza Hut and a Goodyear. So a lot of stuff going on there, and you can't see it on this picture because of the screen size, but to the right of her in the same parking area is Fred's discount super dollar store type deal. And then if you look over to straight in front of her vehicle, she has the a sign that says for sale, kind of off to the left in the grass area next to the highway. So she's in a good area. You can tell it's not going to be a crowded parking lot. It's easy to get in and out. There's multiple probably entrances, what I can assume. And Now, and yeah, I'm noticing the plate is a Tennessee tag, so I wouldn't have Vienna. I just wouldn't. If I did have Vienna, I just wouldn't advertise that it's Vienna. It'd be my hot dog. You know, what kind of dogs you got? All beef Gigi's hot dogs. Okay, so I'm looking at your setup and everything here. This is clean, nice, neat. It's sharp. Okay. I see you have some kind of swooper flag. I don't know if that's your business or theirs or somebody else's. I can't read it, but that if it's yours, great. Kudos to you. Let's go down here real quick and look at this up close of this corner. We were on the other corner a little bit ago. She's got jalapenos, pickles, or peppers. She's doing, it looks like she is doing Chicago dogs, because you can see the little sports peppers in the back. And that's fine if you're doing Chicago dogs. You just don't have to say Vienna. Okay, I'm not trying to beat a dead horse, but it's just, you don't have to say it. So chips look nice, neat, clean. The whole area is clean. Use little things you could do. You know, in a parking lot, you're in a parking lot. So you got this asphalt down here below you, right? So you could always come in and put some indoor outdoor carpet. Buy you a cheap piece, a remnant from Lowe's or Home Depot or any salvage place. You can also find it at your, what are those called? Habitat for Humanity thrift stores. They'll typically have some odd piece of carpeting, okay? You can throw it away because it cost you $3, but it looks nicer under the cart, okay? Now, you don't want some shag carpet that's gonna have mustard in it by the end of the day. You wanna use something that you can spray off with a water hose. But even if it's a cloth type material, you can at least try to clean it. If not, throw it away. You didn't spend a lot of money on it. I try to do indoor outdoor carpet. Love the look of everything. It's going to be a little bit of a headache to carry multiple types of drinks and stuff. I try to keep just a few, you know, the basics. And whether it's Coke or Pepsi products, Coke, Diet Coke, okay. Or Diet Pepsi and Pepsi. Mountain Dew is a must in Tennessee. It's a must, okay? And then you could go with sweet tea bottles, root beer, and that's about it. I wouldn't try to carry the orange crush, the grape crush, until my money was such that I didn't have to worry about it. Because what you do is you add work to your day that you may not need to add, because you sold 6 grapes doesn't mean grape's the popular one. And so you want to just stick to the basics, keep it simple. I like that you have water. Water's a must. If you have nothing else, keep water on your cart, the water bottles for people to buy. Now here's the negative, okay? And there's always something, but this, what I'm going to cover right now, I promise you 9 out of 10 people that send me pictures or video for me to critique or give them suggestions, this is 9 out of 10 will have the same issue, okay? And it's killing a lot of businesses. It kills a lot of businesses. And let me tell you what that is real quick. And if you've watched any critiques, you'll already know, okay? Signage. And let me explain something. And you'll see this repeated in multiple critiques I've done. The critiques that I can't video or can't put up videos on are where it's really brutal, you know, where they have a nasty setup. I did a vendor, I went to him and it was horrible, horrible. I filmed it all in 360, but I couldn't put it out because it would just, one, it would embarrass him. Even though he gave me permission to film it, I don't think he realized how bad it was. This isn't the case here with Gigi. And for most, it isn't. So cleanliness is key, but here's the deal. If you're this car over top of Gigi's head, over there to the left, do you have a clue what Gigi's serving? No, you don't. She's in Tennessee, do you think they've seen many hot dog carts? Nope. Nope. I had people pulling over when I was brand new just to look at my cart to find out what the hell it was. Because they were like, what the hell is this? You know, I see steam coming out of this thing. What you got going on here, boy? You know, that's the kind of stuff I got. I mean, literally, I was having more people pull over for that until I got better signs. Now, when I started, I didn't have good signs. I had cardboard signs, right? But I learned from my dad the Burma Shave trick, which is, I don't know if you can Google that, Burma Shave. Google Burma Shave and then images. Burma Shave was a company that was known for on the interstate having multiple signs down the interstate that told a story, a short story, or something funny. But it all ended up with get our Burma Shave cream, you know. So here's the deal for Gigi's. And this is a deal for a lot. I bet if I went to different vendors all over, this is a big issue, a big problem with vendors, is they're not doing the signage. So if you're across the street over here, without anybody telling you and you not seeing a hot dog cart other than a movie, you're not going to have a clue whether that's something special for Fred's dollar store. What is going on over there? And I don't want to really go ask, you know, what if they're doing something for their employees? Then you see what I'm saying? People are very hesitant to come and ask. Okay. So if you want to maximize your potential at a location, put out signs. Swooper flags are ideal. They're, you know, 15-foot pole with that little wavy flag like you saw. I think it was right here. Okay. You see that swooper flag. Now, I don't know if that's hers and I can't see it. So it could say hot dogs. So I could be, you know, preaching to the choir at this moment and she's already got a sign. But here's something else I like to tell people. If it says hot dogs, that tells what you have, but it doesn't tell the price. Some people are too scared to come up and read the sign because now they're in your bubble. And a lot of people don't want to be in your bubble till they know what you got. So I tell people, make something that's big enough they can see, even if it's on cardboard, out at the road, down the parking lot a little bit, even a small sign, all beef hot dogs, $4, or whatever the price is, but pick something off your list, your menu list, Polish sausage, $4. And people will know, oh, I can go to that. That isn't for Fred's. That it will automatically let them know that you're offering stuff to them, and they'll know what you have to offer. That is crucial. It is key. It is number one, period, by far. Number one importance is to get marketed. Market it, market it, and market it while you're there. That's more important than posting Facebook pictures about it. It's more important to put signs out. And if you're in a bad location, we've talked about that, where you're in a bad location and it's hard to get in and out and you got to stop traffic quick, or it's a busy highway, then you put signs further down the road and you make sure to pick those up when you're done. So when you close up at 2, go get your signs, right? Pack up your cart, go get your signs, keep the area clean, never leave crap on the ground, keep it clean. Make it cleaner than it was when you got there. So those are things you can do. There's other little things I would do. Like, let's say Gigi's is going to be here for a while at this location. I would definitely bring a little mower up here, pay somebody to come up there and for $5 and mow about a 30-foot section along the road there. I'd make it look pretty where I'm at. It would look good where I'm sitting, okay? We've had some vendors go get those little portable pop-up tables. They're picnic tables that fold up flat. And then you open them up, and then you got customers sitting around, okay? Especially in a place like this where she's got plenty of access, it appears. You know, it's a vacant building she's in front of that looked like it had a big parking lot. So there's a lot of opportunity here. Get signage. Never scrimp on that and never wait on it till later. If you have to make your own signs with a $2 poster board or a $1 poster board from Dollar Tree, make a sign. Put signs out and don't try to put your whole menu on the sign. Okay, make it readable, big, hot dogs, all beef, $2, whatever it is. Make it visible, make it so that they know. Don't say, I'm gonna do that once I got some money coming in. Don't wait, okay? So that's my big negative, all right? I hope it didn't hurt any feelings, but it'll make you more money and make you successful. Other than that, this looks great. Gigi, I wish you the best. I hope you kick butt, okay? I'm sure you'll do great. You've got a nice smile. You're friendly. You're going to do good. Just be consistent. Test your locations. Do your record keeping like I teach. And do it simple. and mark down each day where you were, what day, you know, any notes for that day. So you can go back and go, man, Tuesdays in front of Fred's is the bomb, but Wednesdays suck. Or the second week of the month is always better than the rest of the month. You'll figure out those days and then you'll be able to work less and make more money. And that's what it comes down to, is the better use of your time. Because I'm sure Gigi would rather be with me sitting with a cane pole on the side of a pond fishing. Okay, because I love doing that. And I'll do that with you, Gigi, one day. Me and you'll go fishing. If you like fishing. Even if you don't, you can come with me. But you'd rather be doing something like that than to spend your time willy-nillying it with wonder if today's going to be better. I don't keep records. Well, if you want to know about record keeping, I'll put a link, okay? I'll put a link in the description below, and maybe you can check that out, or anybody can check that out, and it'll help you kind of guide you so that within 60 days of vending, you know the spots and you know what days and you know what hours, and you can focus in on those and you'll make so much more money. I promise you. I love you. Thank you, Gigi, for sharing this and allowing me to do this. And I wish you all the best. Talk to you later.